1.
Hi, my name is Laura Neri. I'm reading William Faulkner's address accepting the Nobel Prize in Literature. He actually won this award, according to the board, for his powerful and artistically unique contribution to the American novel. Ladies and gentlemen, I feel that this award was not made to me as a man, but to my work, a life's work in the agony and the sweat of the human spirit, something that which was not there before, not for the glory, but to make out of it the material of the human spirit, so this award is only mine in trust. It will not be hard to find a dedication to the money part of it commensurate with the purpose and significance of its origin. But I would like to go to the same with the acclaim too, by using this fine moment as a pinnacle from which I might be listened to by the young men and women already dedicated to the same anguish and travail, among whom is the one who may someday stand where I stood this afternoon. Our tragedy today is a general and universal physical fear, so long sustained that we can even bear it. There are no longer questions of the spirit. There is only one question: when will I be blown up? Because of this, the young man, young woman writing today has forgotten the problems of the human heart in conflict with itself, which alone can make good writing. That because that is only worth writing about, worth the agony and the sweat. He must learn them again. He must teach himself the basest of all things is to be afraid. And teaching himself that, forget it forever, leaving room in his workshop for the old verities and truths of the heart, the old universal truths lacking which any story is ephemeral and doomed. Love and honor and pity and pride and sacrifice and compassion. Until he does so, he lives under a curse. He writes not of love, but of lust. Not of any defeats, but which nobody loses anything of value, of victories without hope, and worst of all, without pity and compassion. His griefs grieve on no universal bones, leaving no scars. He writes not of the heart, but of the glands. Until he relearns these things, he writes as though he watched the end of man. I decline to accept the end of man. It is easy enough to say that man is immortal simply because he will endure. That when the last ding-dong of doom has clanged and faded, from the last worthless rock hanging tideless in the last red and dying evening, that there will even still be one more sound, that of his puny, inexhaustible voice, still talking. Thank you.
Good job. Great job. What Lauren did.